nature and of nature's God entitled us. A decent respect to the opinions of mankind requires that they should declare the causes which impel them to separation.
We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal.
That they are endowed by their Creator with certain inalienable rights, that among these are
life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness.
That to secure these rights, governments are instituted among men, deriving their just powers from the consent of the governed.
That whenever any form of government becomes destructive of these ends, it is the right of the people to alter or to abolish it, and to institute new government, laying its foundation on such principles and organizing its powers in such form as to them shall seem most likely to affect their safety and happiness.
Prudence will dictate that governments long established should not be changed for light and transient causes. But when a long train of abuses and usurpations, events are designed to reduce them under absolute despotism, it is their right, it is their duty to throw off such government and to provide new guards for their future security.
We, therefore, the representatives of the United States of America in General Congress assembled,
appealing to the Supreme Judge of the world for the rectitude of our intentions, do in the name and by the authority of the good people of these colonies solemnly publish and declare
that these United Colonies are and of right ought to be free and independent states.
That they are absolved from all allegiance to the British Crown.
And that all political connection between them and the state of Great Britain is
and ought to be
totally dissolved.
And for the support of this declaration, with a firm reliance on the protection of divine providence, we mutually pledge to each other
our lives, our fortunes, and our sacred honor.
Attached to this document are the names of 56 men.
Collectively, we refer to them as the Founding Fathers.
We are not them!